6.
Hello everybody, welcome back to Macrothon 2023, and this is the final run of the day. We have Kazan, who is running Gran Turismo 2, the all licenses category, so I will let you take it away.
Hello everyone, and yeah, welcome for this last run of the marathon. Really excited to show you guys Gran Turismo 2 all licenses, so... Yeah, we will go all through 60 license tests, and 6 licenses this is, from B1 to S10. So, what we'll further do, let's start the countdown. 3, 2, 1, go! So, yeah, Gran Turismo 2, I guess everybody knows this game in Macrothon. Since it's usually racing games enthusiast up there. So I don't think this game needs much introduction, and yeah, we start with one of the best cars in the run, the Toyota Yaris. And yeah, this car will suffer driving through the 1 kilometer straight of test course, and yeah, it's a classic accelerate and brake test, as usual in the start of these runs. So we have to stop in the checkered zone, so... We just take our marker here and stop. And yeah, so when you angle your car, you can actually slow down faster than if you go in a straight line. I think the optimal angle to slow down is 45 degrees. So yeah, this is the US version of the game. We have 3 accelerate and brake tests to do with gradually faster cars. The Fiat Coupe is already quite a bit faster than the Yaris we got in the previous test. But yeah, this is the US version of the game. So it's the main reason we use that is because it has faster loading time than PAL, and also the Japanese version has different rally physics that are slower. Which is why we are not using that one. So what the fact that we're playing US version means that we are actually stuck in freedom units. We cannot change it in the options. And I think that's also the case. Maybe you can change in European version, I'm not sure, but yeah, in the US one at least you are stuck with those units, sadly. So now we drive the R34 for the last accelerate and brake test. Quite a shame that the only test we get to drive the R34 is accelerate and brake. So now we'll come to a test that is very tough for Dutchie for some reason. Even though he's very good at this game, he struggled with this test. Which is a 2-lap circle around with a Nissan Micra or Marge, depending on where you live. And yeah, you need to smooth steer, so I guess on D-pad this test could be a bit tricky. But if you smooth steer and stay close to the curb, you should be good. And there we go. So now we'll drive a bigger circle. The previous one was 30 meters radius, and this one is 50. But we also drive a much faster car. We drive a Subaru Impreza. So this time we cannot get it flat out, so we'll try to stay as close to the curb. Ideally you don't want to mount it though, because the curb is angled, so it will pushes you it will push you back when you mount it, and yeah, it will cost you a bit of momentum. So we just try to get it as close as possible, and there we go. So now B6, and we drive one of the most iconic Gran Turismo cars, and it's the only time in the run we are gonna see it. I'm of course speaking about the wonderful Demio. So yeah, sadly the only time in the run where we see it. And this corner is flat out if done correctly. And looks like that would be the case. Yep, it's flat out. Sometimes you have to release if the timing of the turning in is not right. But this time it went fine. So now we'll move to B7. And now it's a rolling start on the same same track section, but this time with a much faster car, Honda Integra. And we will have to release actually on this one. So it's a bit tougher. The license tests of course are meant to be gradually tougher. Even though that doesn't mean the gold time necessarily becomes harder and harder to beat, some of the early tests have pretty tight gold times. And the other way around, some of the later tests are pretty easy to get gold on. But yeah, the test itself usually involves more complex driving the further we go in the run. The last license being only full lap runs. So still with Integra that we'll see a lot in the run. This time in a U-turn, hairpin, a pretty wide hairpin. That should be some decent speed. Sadly we didn't get gold on the previous test. That's the first missed goal we got. 23.1 is a pretty good time though here. And now we are gonna drive on B9 and B10, which are driven by with a Ford Cougar. So both tests are identical except that this one is a standing start and the next one will be rolling. And yeah, basically you want to stay as much to the left as possible here, because there is this right corner coming up. It's thrown a bit too much here, but at least I will have a good angle for the exit. Sadly I didn't keep very good speed. And yeah, barely under gold. Usually there's some room on this one to get a gold on, it's pretty easy. Also on some of these tests, if you play on manual transmission, the game will spawn you in the rev limiters, that includes this one. And if that happens, luckily you can buffer inputs before the test starts, so you can just hold. On the test where that happens, I just hold the upshift button and it will shift up as soon as loading time is over. So sadly we didn't get gold here, but that's B license done. That's B license done and we are gonna move to the A license, and yeah, we can enjoy some more PS1 transition screens in the menus. So A1 is as well a braking test, but this time with a rolling start. So we are gonna be at much higher speed than the test on B, as you can see. Actually the first time I went for all golds, I had quite some trouble on this one. Quite hard to figure out which mark to use. Oh, I braked way too early here, but it's okay, I could fix it. That's A1 done. Now we're gonna go to A2. So on this one, even though you don't start at the rev limiter, you still want to buffer the gear up because this car has massive torque. So yeah, if you shift up to 4, you will just have a better acceleration at the lower RPM. And hopefully we can get the good line here. Oh, I slowed down a bit too well. I still could save it decently though, still 20.98 even though it was not perfect, so I'm pretty happy with that. So now we are gonna see the Integra again. So this is the same as B7, except we start at 150 kph instead of 50 in B. So it makes yeah, the braking zone much heavier and the car more understeered as a result. Also the gold time is a bit tougher to beat on this one than on the B license one. And now we are gonna see one of the worst cars in the run, and unfortunately, it will follow us for other tests in A license. It's the Altezza, yeah, this car. I think everybody who tried licenses on this game hates this car. Or at least I do. Yeah, that was a bit of a slow apex speed, but yeah. Other than the different car, it is the same test as the previous one. And yeah, this test is one of the very few where the gold time is tougher on NTSC than on PAL. It's only by half a tenth, but on such a short test, it makes it a lot harder actually to get gold on that. The 0.05 difference really is bigger than you think it is. Because getting 0.350 is not too hard, but getting 300 is can be a pain. So this test is a bit scary as well. The car likes to understeer a lot, and the corner is tighter than it looks. And we are gonna drive it again with the Altezza, which is a bit less understeery but also more slidey.
So just to ask, have you got a favourite car?
In the run or in the game in general?
Yeah, favourite license test.
Favourite license test? I like S1 with a Mini, I think it's pretty fun. Overall, I would say I prefer the... Oh, did my controller disconnect? Okay, I think it reconnected. Let's see. Okay, I'm fine. So yeah, I would say I like the S license more because it's a full lap test, and yeah, this is more enjoyable to me than just grinding a short test with only one or two corners. So yeah, it would maybe S1 actually, or S4 with the Pennzoil.
Nice.
Yeah, I know you like this one as well. Because you did it in
GT3. Oh, it's not this one, is it? The friggin' meme that... Is that a Supra? Usual crap. Oh,
yeah,
no.
We're gonna see the Supra a bit more in the run.
I'm pretty sure Tomb, who's in chat, by the way, I'm pretty sure... I think it's him that's got... Or maybe it's somebody else. Someone's got the open mouth of the Supra. I think it's like Tom Supra or Tom S or something is like the emote. Yeah, something like that.
So yeah, we're moving
mine back to ESA.
A9, which is a test where you drive it on A9 with a Mitsubishi and on A10 with a Supra. And yeah, it's a bit tricky because you want to cut that inside corner, but if I put four wheels in the grass, I have to redo the test. I fail the test and. I really want to cut it a lot here, as much as I could. But yeah, if I cut one pixel too far, I have to redo the race. And it actually happened to me at ESA, on my ESA run on this one, on A10. I cut it too much.
Even though I was there for that, I actually forgot about that.
Oh, you forgot about that, yeah. It happened on this one.
I'm sure there was one, I think, was it at... I can't remember if it was... You didn't fail the Toyota GT1 one, did you?
This one is the only one I failed at ESA. At least the only one where I had to restart. Of course, some tests were bad, but yeah. That's A license done. But yeah, some tests were bad in ESA, but the only one I had to redo was A10. So yeah, A license done. So two down, six left. The first, the licenses also tend to get longer to complete, because the tests tend to get longer as well. Even though in this game, it's not as true in the other Gran Turismo game, but on this game, pretty much all the license tests are pretty short. Even on IB and IA, actually, only the S ones are a lot longer due to being one lappers.
Well. Whilst you're doing the license test, have we got time for a quick donation?
Yes, absolutely.
Perfect. So we have a $8 donation from Flying Dutchy.
Oh.
That we both know. that says, last donation from me at the end of the marathon. I had a blast watching and running myself on both days. Let's go, cousin. Go get them, dude. Go get them golds. Or get them golds, whichever way to put it. Thank you very much, Dutchie.
I try my best. Oh, don't go too far. Wow, that was close. It was not very fast because that sand slowed me down quite a lot, but this was 3-in-1 piece. Sadly, with the bronze of shame. But we take it. So this test, especially the next one after that, is a famous meme of this game. So this one is the easier version, IC3, because as you can see here, you can cut the inside to make it a bit easier for you. You can use a bit of the grass to get tighter apexes. And you can see that the goal time is 20.2, so you will say, yeah, this is fine, I just got a 20.0. This should not be too hard, right? But on the next test, it's the same layout, and the goal time is the same, 20.2 as well. But you will have these walls on the inside, and now you cannot cut anymore, so you have to make more distance. And this test is very famous for being super hard to gold on. And actually, like, I golded it a few times, but never in a full game, like full license run attempt. And yeah, that won't be the one either. But yeah, this one is very famous for being stupidly hard to gold. I think the world record, Tume can maybe correct me on that, I think it's like 0.93, I think. So it's less than 3/10 faster than the gold time. So yeah, you don't really have much room for error. So yeah, this test is, even though it's not too hard, usually, if you grind it, the gold time is not too hard. In a full run, it's a bit scary, because you don't have much room, it's a pretty fast corner. And actually, the next one is almost identical, you redo the same section, but this time is the finish line, you have one more corner to do. And it was the same car, so yeah. Pretty interesting. Then the only case where in the game where they do that to test in a row where you do a longer version in the second one. Oh, I didn't gold this one. Usually on this one you have quite some room for from the gold time, but I still didn't get it. That was a bit slow. I was a bit too cautious. Because yeah, you can get at least a 0.0 here. Oh my god, I almost went off track here. So this is the hairpin of midfield, pretty tight hairpin. And yeah, we are a bit behind the gold. So the next one is this, almost identical, except you drive the S2000. Which is a rear-wheel drive, so it's less understeery than the Celica we had, but it's a bit more slidey, though. Especially coming into that braking zone. And yeah, this was a bit slow. So that's another bronze in your bag, in our bag. So this one also is infamously hard for being very hard to gold. It's even the only test where the demo run doesn't gold, actually. It does a 0.20. There is a wall hit, though, that can make it a bit easier, but also more random. That we'll do right here. So it's pretty random, so you won't get gold every time with that, but if you try for long enough, you will eventually get it. You could even maybe get the world record with a lucky enough world ride here. And last test of IC license, which is the only Gran Turismo game to have an IC license here. And it's on Seattle with the Corvette. In Freedom Units, so if there's some Americans watching, this is your moment. Won't be your only one, but it's your first moment. And that's it for License International C. So in terms of license test, we are halfway through, but time-wise, we are far from it, of course. Mainly because of S. Because actually, since we drive a faster and faster car, the test don't get that much longer. Because, yeah, for example, when you drive the Yaris in B, even though the test is not very long, it takes a lot of time for the Yaris to get there. So now Viper will like this probably. IB1 is the first rally test in the run. And we drive the 99 Subaru.
Oh yes. Love me some rally.
So yeah, sadly rallying has never really been the strongest point of Gran Turismo game. Never been a fan of the rally physics in when it comes to Gran Turismo. It always has been pretty weird. And we almost failed gold on rally test in the US version. It would have been very embarrassing. Because on the US version of the game, the gold times are very easy on all rally tests. At least the one not involving asphalt. And the reason for that is because the Japanese version, has a slower rally physics, as I said before. But they didn't really readjust the times when they changed the physics for the US version of the game. They only fixed the times in the European version. So if you play on European versions, then the rally were. The rally times were harder for you than it was for the Americans. So IB3, I don't really know why this test is in IB. Because you drive a pretty slow car on the same layout you use on A. And even though I barely beat it, the gold time is really nothing special to get on there. You have quite some... You have quite some margin. So... Yeah, don't really know why. This one, however, is justified to be in IB. Because the gold time is much tougher and the car as well is much tougher to drive. So yeah, we stay in second gear to get a bit more turn in. And we barely miss out on gold. My exit was not the best here. The entry was pretty good. So this one is we drive the 98 Mustang, and it's a double left. Can be a bit scary because you want to enter the first one pretty fast, and then slow down more in between the two corners to keep more entry speed. That was a bit cautious. Like, let's see what the time is. Ah yeah, we are missing gold by not much. I went a bit too cautiously because obviously when you're on if you try to aim for a PB, for example, yeah, any restart of test you would do would kill the run essentially. Oh yeah, we are coming to the slalom test. So this one is the easier one, but yeah, these are the two big run killers. Here on this one, luckily sometimes if you crash on these walls, since you're going so slow, you can get away with it and still finish the event, and you have quite some margin to the bronze time. So it's not as much of a run killer as the other one. But yeah, we have one test in between before that other one. Which this one is pretty hard to gold on US version as well. Oh. And yeah, that will definitely not be a goal. That was a very bad corner. It probably won't even be silver, to be honest. But yeah, what matters is to not die in the next test, which will be the fast slalom with the S2000. When you're on PB pace, this run is quite scary. If you want a PB attempt to go, yeah. It's not really, a run is not really a run until you get past this part. Okay, that was not too bad. I think I will miss out on gold though, but I'm alive, plus with a decent time, so it's really all I can ask for, really. So I B9. For some reason, there's only 2 tenths between gold and silver on this one in the US version. So it's the only one where it's actually not too shameful to get bronze on. That's fixed in the European version. On PAL, the gold time is the same, but they made the server time slower. And now we are playing as you, Viper, for IB10, also a famous test.
I was going to say, is it the corkscrew one?
Yes, it's the corkscrew one.
Yeah.
Known, the traumatized generation of kids.
Oh my god, I hated this one. Even on GT3, it was bad.
Yep, I still hate it to this day.
Yeah, I don't blame you, genuinely speaking. Yeah. Like, the Viper's just a handful anyway. Corkscrew is a unique corner, yeah. I will give it that, but just for 1 second, I just need to mention this. Like, with Laguna Seca, I think that's how you pronounce it, with it having a unique corner with the corkscrew, somebody actually mentioned doing an F1 race.
Yeah, you would destroy the floor, I think, on this.
Yeah. I'm like, wouldn't the front bumper just, or whatever it is, yeah, the front wing, wouldn't it not just smash into the floor and you just, like, the car would just tip upright?
Because I think yeah, because they drive IMSA on Laguna Seca, and I think the prototypes don't do that race. The IMSA round of Laguna Seca is only for GT classes, I think. Most likely
like
because the prototypes cannot make it either. So we are driving as you again on the circle, and we want to start 6 second gear and shift to third as fast as possible to not get too much sliding. And yeah, we can get back to what you were saying.
It's just like with F1 cars being as low as they are anyway, the only way you're really going to get an F1 car through Laguna Seca, to be honest, is Mons and R Factor and a set of cars. So that's it. You wouldn't be able to get a real F1 car through there.
Yeah, or maybe at very low speed. Maybe at very low speed it can make it. I think they made it in show laps. Like, yeah, I think they already got F1 cars on Laguna Seca, but they never put it in race speed.
Well, IndyCar races there, apparently, according to what Tomb has said.
I'm not sure.
I think
it does still.
It
used to. It used to, but I'm not sure it does.
They still do.
I'm not sure
actually.
I wouldn't bet on that. I wouldn't bet on if they still do or not. I think they don't anymore, but yeah, I wouldn't bet money.
Ah yes, the TVR Griffith. TVR, a company so bad at making cars they fall apart, apparently.
And that's coming from a British.
Yeah, there's a reason. Like, the one thing that I always wanted a TVR when I was younger, and I got told, don't get a TVR because they're terrible, because they are kit cars, they break down and they blow up dead easily. Bit like Lamborghinis, to be fair, they set on fire. The cars, in my opinion, TVRs look great, they race pretty good. The problem is they're not very reliable as road cars, that's it.
Yeah.
They're more of a, I don't know, I don't want to say track car, but they are more meant towards tracks than they are and racing than they are on the road.
So yeah,
and if someone drives on the road, fair enough.
That would have been a gold on PAL. Unfortunately, it's super hard to get gold on the NSX one in NTSC. It's like, I think the record is 0.68, 29.68, and the gold time is 30 flat. So yeah, only 0.32 of runway. On that one. Luckily, the next one is a rally, so obviously on US version it's the complete opposite. We could drink a coffee and still get gold. And yeah, also
it's
a car
easy,
you should like, I
oh
guess.
Oh my god, it actually is.
Escort
it's that one.
And now the Escudo. The only time we'll see the Escudo in the run, so the best car in the game, this time for real. I lied, it's not the Demio, it's this monster.
Oh my.
So yeah, the trick here is to get slow apex speed. And yeah, try to then get out of the corner with straight wheels as soon as possible.
The Escudo is not real, it can't hurt you. Oh no, it's real, alright.
Luckily for us, it is, because. Yeah. I guess an entire generation of players.
Let's be fair.
Entire generation of kids who love this car now.
Yeah. Let's be fair. How many people didn't know about the Escudo until Gran Turismo?
I didn't. I mean,
I'm guaranteed that's probably about 90% of people I know.
But I mean,
or 95%.
I was 8 years old when I first played the Escudo in this game, so can't blame me, I guess, for not knowing it at 8 years old.
Also, here's the French refrigerator, as Brianak calls it.
But yeah, that means all the kids from that time don't know about Pike Peaks, but they know about the Escudo.
Because up until Gran Turismo, like, my first Gran Turismo was 3. I didn't play the first two. So had I played this, I don't know if it was in the first game, but had I played this one, then I would have found out about it when I was younger. So before I played Gran Turismo 3, I never knew what the Escudo was. I didn't even take note of the name of the Escudo until I actually was like, wow, this car's really quick all of a sudden. So
yeah, I figured about it with Gran Turismo 2. Oh, nice gold here. I don't get this one pretty often on runs. But yeah, I knew because of that game. And actually, it's funny because it was not that good of a car in real life. I don't think it ever won Pike Peaks. It's a bit like the Minolta in GT4. Like,
it
was
honest,
a terrible car. It was a terrible car in real life, but for some reason, when it comes to prototypes in all Gran Turismo game, it's the ultimate weapon, the Minolta.
I can't disagree with what Tomb said, which is, well, to be fair, the Escudo is as it should be in GT3. In GT2, it doesn't make any sense.
What? Yeah, because in GT3 it can get light speed, which is true Escudo.
Yeah, the one that can take
off.
Yeah,
it makes more sense in GT3.
Like a million miles an hour.
Yeah. It can only get 400 something in Gran Turismo 2, meanwhile Gran Turismo 3 can get its true speed. So corkscrew again.
Was like, yep. Wait, isn't the test course in GT2?
It is.
Can you not do the trick with the wheelie thing?
That's only in GT3.
Yeah, but surely you can adjust it. Mind you, then again, I don't know if you can adjust like the downforce
also,
and stuff.
Test course in GT2 is different than in GT3. It's a lot shorter track.
Also, the Toyota that looks like it's been through...
Yep, the 98 GT1.
It's been through an interesting paint shop, let's just say that for this one.
Yep.
I would say what it actually looks like, but I'm not gonna. It's just a unique art style, that's all I'm saying.
Yeah,
it's
that's
a Toyota. Yeah.
98 GT1. We will see the 99 GT1 in the very last test in the game. The only way to get the 99 GT1 as well is to gold all the S licenses.
Is the road car in this?
Yes, it is as well. And actually, the road car is used in any percent, in the normal any percent. Because you can buy it for only 1 million and equip a level 4 turbo on it. Which make it over 1000 horsepower, I think, or close to it. And yeah, then it becomes really fast. It's a bit slower than the Escudo, but it's... The thing is, you don't have the money for the Escudo in any percent by that time, so...
Also, if I'm right in saying, oh, here's your favourite one, by the way.
Yep.
I think I'm right in saying the Escudo is in the... I think there's a rally category, isn't there, for GT2?
Yes.
If I'm not mistaken. And you use the Escudo in that, right?
You have it as an opponent. You can use any car you want. You can use any car you want to beat it, but...
Obviously
it's hard to beat an Escudo with anything else than an Escudo. I mean, I guess you can build it with the Cultus as well, which is another Suzuki Pike Peaks car. Which is actually almost as fast as the Escudo, but it's the forgotten one. But yeah.
So when's Mini Cooper percent? Because of the fact it was part of CMR2 once upon a time. Surely GT2 can do it.
Actually, the Mini is probably better in GT2 than it is in CMR2, this one. This one also, if
I mean,
you...
yeah, it's a racing one.
Also, if you want to defeat the GT40 in that infamous Rome Historic Cup car race, your best weapon for that is this Mini, actually, because it's only 140 HP. So it's well, it's well below the horsepower limit, and as you can see, it's still pretty fast. So, yeah.
I love that.
Out of all cars, out of all cars, I beat the GT40 with. This one was the easiest by far. And yeah, speaking of GT40, there it is.
Just coincidence.
Yeah.
Speak of the devil, it shall appear.
Just after
what I never understand is the fact that the classic... this is a classic car, it's a classic muscle car. But yet... yeah, it's a classic muscle car, but yet... they decided to put this in the... in that particular race, the Rome Circuit, classic car cut, whatever it was. It's like... I mean,
it's technically,
let's be fair. Yeah, no, I get that, because obviously that's what the... hence the reason why it's in the cup in the first place. But you'd think it'd be the other way around. You'd think the player would enter that race or that cup with something that's OP, because let's be fair, in GT... pretty much most Gran Turismo games you can do that.
Where you can take you can do that in a lot of races.
Way OP and beat most things half the time. But you can't in this one. Like, don't get me wrong, GT 3, 4, I don't know about 5 onwards, but 3 and 4, it's like, huh.
Yeah, it gets worse with the game onwards. This one is actually the one where you can the least abuse of it, and you can still quite a bit. Like, there is that... you know, there's a 90-80 Historic Car Cup, and I think the horsepower limit is like over 400 horsepower, like 440 or something. Yeah, and for some reason the opponents are like very slow compared to that horsepower limit. Like, even with the stock, you know, pop-up light Supra, you can beat them. And we use that to our advantage in the Any% Japanese. Because in that version of the game, you can pretty much enter the Gran Turismo World Championship as soon as you have the International A license. So you just drive the licenses, you drive the 80 car race with a starter car because the opponents are slow. And yeah, you get one of the most OP race cars in the game, the R30 Silhouette Formula, and you go to the end of the game.
Also, one thing that always bugged me about GT2, especially with this Subaru, it looks more purple than it does blue.
Yeah, but there's several Impreza rally cars in this game.
This is 99,
and I think there's like the 95 or 96 as well.
Isn't there a black one?
That's in GT1.
Oh, I thought it was two. Never mind.
Yeah, in GT1, all the dealership race cars, they come in two colors. So the Subaru you can choose between blue and black, but on the sequels, like GT2 onwards, they only kept the blue color. Oh, you can get the black one in this game. I didn't know that.
I think so. Was I right when I said you can
only
get
the road
black
car? I think.
Isn't
it only the road version that you can race modify in black?
I don't know.
I think the actual race car is blue only on GT2.
If I'm being honest, Tomb's the GT2 Wikipedia, in my opinion, out of all of us here.
Yeah, true.
Tomb might be able to tell us, maybe.
But yeah, I remember the older Subaru is like the 90s, I don't know if 95 or 96, but that one looks way more blue than the one we saw.
I know there's the blue one, which you've just been racing. We talked about the black Subaru. Surely there's a red one.
Like, that's the white and red from Super GT, yeah. The Cusco.
No, as in like the rally version.
Oh.
I'm sure there's a red one, although I don't know if that's GT1 or 2 that I've seen that in. But
in
I'm
GT1
sure
you can have
in...
it blue or black. Maybe with a race modification from the stock cars, but I'm not
unless
sure.
It was in the beta for some reason. Unless I'm thinking of a beta car. I mean, I doubt it, but you never
There's
know.
quite a few beta cars, like there's some NASCAR's livery and stuff. So yeah, I said this one, S4, was one of my favorite in the game. Now this one is one of my least. Because yeah, this car is really bad. And this track is pretty difficult as well. And it's only in GT2, Grindelwald. And the mountain you can see up there is Eiger. The mountain though will reappear in GT5 onwards with the track Eiger Nordwand, which is located just a few kilometers away from this one. But this one never appeared again in GT games. So it can be a nice track, but definitely not with this car. Because on the bumps it's very unpredictable. Yeah, like this. And also, luckily for us, the hitboxes of the grass are a bit lenient, as you can see here. I wasn't fully in the grass, even though it looks like it. Because the grass actually doesn't start where it looks like it starts. It's a pretty fast section here. So this is the race modified Lotus Europa. But it doesn't make it much better. Uh-oh. Yeah, I had to slow down extra. I love the texture of that spoiler being too small for the resolution of the PS1, so it disappears and appears occasionally on the screen. It's pretty funny. Too thin for PlayStation 1 360p. And yeah, that's not a very good time, but bad time for a bad test. It's fine.
I mean, that technically goes hand in hand, right?
Yep. But that means we won't get the GT1 at the end, unfortunately. Because we need all golds on this license to get it. I don't remember how you get the other GT1, the one you absolutely love the paint on. But it's easier for sure, it's like one race event.
Well, what I was asking before was, is the road car in
Yes,
this?
It is.
Because you got the race car, aren't you? So.
Yeah, it is. You can buy it from the dealership, and that's what you do in any percent PAL USM. You, yeah, once you complete the Continental Championship, you buy the GT1 road car for the World Championship. And it's very fast because you can equip the level 4 turbo on it. I believe in GT3 it's OP as well for the same reasons.
Yeah. Yeah, you can do the wheelie trick that you can do with the Escudo. Yeah.
But I remember as a kid,
that was good though, I don't think.
As a kid, I figured that the GT1 road car was pretty OP, because... Yeah, I unlocked it from I don't know what event it is, I don't remember. But I remember winning the GT1 road car, and then I was like using it 80% of the time.
I think the race car was better than the road car.
Even with level 4 turbo on the road car?
Yeah, only just. Like, I found that by doing the wheelie, it was quick. It pulled the wheelie faster than it did on the road car.
But I mean, when it comes to raw pace.
I don't know. I've not really checked.
At least it had higher top speed when driven normally, at least GT1.
To be fair with GT3, I actually drove the Viper GTSR Team Orica.
Oh, but here it is. Is this
test?
The devil. Yes, it is.
In my opinion, the wrong one, but either way, this was the GT2 version. I meant the one from 2000?
Yeah, I think this one is a 98, I think, Viper, and the one from Gran Turismo is a 3, is a 2000. The red one.
Yeah, the red one, yeah.
And this one
That's
is a
favorite.
98. Oh no. Oh my god, how did I get away with that? That was close. Because yeah, even though the sand in Laguna Seca in this game for some reason has the same grip as asphalt, yeah, it's still considered off-track in the licenses, so I can't go there. If it was just a normal race, I would abuse that, but I cannot. So yeah, one last time through that corner. You know, I think the corkscrew is a unique corner for a reason. Like, there's a reason nobody else made a corner like that?
Pretty much.
Oh no, where am I going? Okay, I could save it. One more corner. Not the easiest one though. Keeping in third gear because wheel spin. I think that will not be gold. Yeah, that will not be gold. There's no way. Yeah, it's pretty far from it actually, but... Yeah, usually this one is a bit scary when you're at a good pace, because it's really easy to kill the run on that. And now we are coming on S8, which is Farrod will like it.
This is the Evo, isn't it?
Yeah, it's the Tommy Evo. So, on this version you don't see the Tommy, but I'm pretty sure in the European one, the Tommy shows up. The Tommy livery. Could be wrong, but I remember the Tommy livery being in GT2 when I was a kid. Even though I didn't know who was what was the Tommy standing for.
To be fair, until I played CMR2, I didn't realise what Tommy was either. I only knew of Colin McRae, and that was it when I was younger. Now, as I grew older and started
to watch, because he's the only real driver in CMR2, so you didn't know about any of the other guys.
Pretty much. It was the same with Colin McRae Rally 1. You'd be surprised at how many real-life drivers are in the first game.
There's more than... There's the real drivers, right, in CMR1?
There's a lot of it. Yeah. A lot of... I think about... Well, in the European version, there is. If you play the Japanese... Oh, I don't know about Japanese, actually. You played the American release, a lot of the all the drivers apart from McRae are replaced, and I don't know any of them whatsoever.
So yeah, unlike USA, this won't be an ILPB on this one, because this is much worse so far. Luckily, on the US version, the goal time is really bad, but you can beat it by over 15 seconds. Well, yeah. Technically you can over 15 seconds, but my PB is 14 ahead. It was a bit too much sliding. Ideally you want to keep a slow expect speed with not too much sliding. That would still at least be a PAL goal as well, because on PAL I think it's 155 flat, I think. So yeah, two more tests left to go. And the next one is a... interesting one, because it's it only appears in this game and on very few races. So it appears only on this test in arcane mode, but if you want to play it in arcane mode, you need the S license to unlock it. And then it doesn't show up in any event. The only races you can get Rome Knight on is either through event generator or through the manufacturer races, the one make races. Because in those races, the racetrack is random. So out of every track in the game, it can roll this one. So that means that there's actually a lot of... And also, the S license is not mandatory to complete the game, pretty much. Except for the event generator. So any other event, you can just do it with IA, so... That means that a lot of players who played this game actually never knew that track was in the game. They never saw that track, even though they played the game when they were younger. And that track never appeared in Gran Turismo since. Rome Knight. I like this track though. It's probably among my favorite tests as well. Enjoyable track, enjoyable car. And yeah, I don't know if this will be golden or not. Let's see. Oh, it is! Nice. So one more test to go. And it will be the better version of the GT1. The 99. So the end of this track is pretty tricky, because you might know the last chicane of Apricot Hill, and usually you get cut through it, right? You just go flat out. Every kid did that. Nobody took this corner legitimately, but... thing is, on this test you have to, otherwise... You have to redo the test. You cannot go forward on the grass, so... you cannot do the cut you always do. And yeah, it's pretty tight. It's pretty scary. At least it's not like GT3 time trial, where they put cones on it. Makes it even scarier. But still, even when you are done with the run, you're on PB pace, you have to go through that. Let's try to not choke it. That's exactly what I'm doing. One more corner. And time is coming up on the finish line. And time. Hello?
GG.
Yeah.
49.05.
49.05, wow.
Yeah, yeah, what was your PB?
My PB is, so recorded PB is 48.29. But in the ESL practice room, I got 24. But sadly, I didn't record that. So yeah, maybe we can make a funny name here. To close it out. So yeah, we got the S license. We got them all. Now we could beat the game, but I guess that would be for another marathon, because that's where this category ends. Yeah, the rest of the game would be for another time, I guess. So yeah, thank you, McPherson, for having me and having me as the last run. On top of that, I'm delighted to to do the closure of this marathon, and it was also a bit of a mess to reschedule my time because of my abilities, but in the end it all went smooth, and it was a great time, it was a great marathon. I hope you guys enjoyed it as much as I did, and I hope the hosts, the organizers, did it as well.
Yeah, we've very much enjoyed having you. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
And that's it for me. So I guess coming up would be some kind of closing speech or whatever. So it's all yours.
No worries. Thank you very much, Kazan. We really appreciate it. We're going to go to a quick intermission. When we come back, we will have, as Kazan was saying, we'll have the closing speech with myself, with Brianak, and with Joseph. So stick around, and we'll be back after this short intermission. See you shortly.